हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम अरीना इंटरनेशनल मास्टर एंड फिडे इंस्ट्रक्टर ऋषिकेश चव्हाण। वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे इन बेसिक टैक्टिक्स वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट रिमूविंग द डिफेंडर। इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज रिमूविंग द गार्ड और डिस्ट्रॉइंग द गार्ड और इवन एलिमिनेशन ऑफ द डिफेंस। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। व्हेन यू आर प्लेइंग अगेंस्ट अ गुड प्लेयर इज नॉट गोइंग टू गिव यू एनी फ्री पीसेस, ही विल कीप ऑल हिज पीसेस सपोर्टेड। So in that case, you will have to find some other way to win extra material. So for example, in this position, as you can see, we are attacking the bishop, but right now the bishop is supported by the knight. So that way we are not getting any extra material. But here, if we can remove this knight, so this knight is the defender of the bishop. So if we can remove this knight, then we can get the bishop for free. So what you are supposed to do, you are supposed to find a piece which is under attack, then you have to find a piece which is defending the attack piece. So in this case, bishop is under attack and this knight is the defender. So if we can remove the defender, then we are getting that bishop for free. So here we are going to capture the knight, and if he captures our bishop back, we'll be getting this bishop for free. Let's move to the next position. Now here again we have to find what weakness is attacked. Now you must remember the five universal weaknesses we discussed in our double attack lesson. So these five weaknesses are exposed king, hanging or unsupported piece, an important square, not so well supported piece, and more valuable piece. So you need to find any one or couple of weaknesses out of these five universal weaknesses. Now in this position, as you can see, black king is trapped on the back rank by his own pawns. So we can say black's back rank is weak. In this case, any check on the back rank can be a checkmate. But right now, this rook is defending the checkmate. For example, let's say if this rook is not over here, then maybe we can simply play rook e8 and it's a checkmate. So we can say that this rook is defending the important square, or this rook is defending the checkmate square. So we have to remove the defender. Now, how to remove the defender? So there are four different ways to remove the defender. The first and the easiest way is to capture the defender. So here we are going to capture the rook. It's a check. Black is forced to capture the queen. And then once the defender is gone, there is no one guarding the back rank, and now we can give a simple checkmate by playing rook e8. Let's move to the next puzzle. Okay, now here again, let's start finding opponents which piece is under attack. So as you can see, this bishop is under attack. Bishop is attacked by the rook, and also this knight is under attack. Knight is attacked by the bishop. Now, next step is find out the defender who is defending the attacked piece. So this knight is defending the bishop, and this knight has a couple of supports. Pawn is supporting the knight and king is supporting this knight. So we'll focus on the bishop, and then we'll focus on the bishop's defender, that is the knight. So here we have to simply capture the knight. Of course, it's a check. Whether it's a check or not, black will have to recapture the piece. So if he recaptures, we are going to capture the bishop, which is now without any support. So we successfully removed the defender, and then we got the bishop for free. Let's move on. Now here again, we are white. So slowly, slowly, there will be more and more pieces over the board, so that we'll be able to find out this tactic even in the crowded position. So we are white. Let's find which black piece is under attack, and then we'll find who is the defender. So there are two black pieces which are under attack, knight and bishop. Knight is attacked by the rook, and the bishop is attacked by our knight. Now let's find the defenders. This bishop is defending the knight, and rook is defending the bishop. Right now we cannot reach to this rook. This rook is too much inside, or too deep inside black's position. So it is difficult for us to reach to that rook. But we can definitely do something about this bishop. We'll simply capture the bishop, and once this defender is gone, we'll be picking up the knight on the next move. So knight into f6, forced, rook into f6, And then, as now there is no defender, we are going to pick up this knight for free. Next position. Okay. Now we are black. It is black to play. Let's find if is there is any attacked piece in white's position. Of course, this d4 knight is under attack and it is supported by other knight, which is that f3 knight. Now let's try and remove the knight. As you can see, we cannot capture the knight. So here we'll use the second way to remove the defender. The second way to remove the defender is attack the defender. So here we'll be pushing the pawn ahead. Now once this knight is attacked by a smaller piece or a smaller pawn, he will have to move. If the knight moves away, for example, let's see if we play something like knight h2. Now once the knight moves, now there is no piece defending this knight and we are going to capture this knight for free. Just in case if that knight is not moving, so after we attack the knight with g4, if this f3 knight doesn't move, then we'll simply capture the knight first. And that way again we are getting more material. Next position. Okay, now can you find what we are attacking or what weakness is under attack? We are white, you have to find black's weakness. So you can pause this video and find out what weakness white is attacking. Yes, you are right. White is trying to give checkmate on this g7 square with the help of this rook. Right now this checkmate is not possible because this knight on e6 is defending the checkmate square. So before white can checkmate black king, white will have to remove the guard. White will have to remove this defender on e6. So can we capture the knight? Can we capture the defender? No, right now it's not possible in this position. But we can definitely attack the defender. So we'll be playing f5. Now if he moves the knight away, then we are going to capture the pawn and we'll give checkmate. And if he knows that checkmate is coming up, and if he saves the checkmate by playing something like g6, then we'll simply capture the knight and that way we will get extra points. So here again, to find the attacked piece or to find the defender, you must find one of the five weaknesses we have already discussed in double attack chapter. Next position. Okay. So here it is white to play. White gives this check. So there is no way to move the king away. So the only way to stop the check is to play queen f8. Now it is white to play. Let's try and find out if we can remove the defender or not. So first step, which black piece is under attack? Queen. Second step, which piece is defending the attacked piece? King. So we came to know that king is the defender. And now we will try to remove the defender. The first way to remove the defender is capture. Of course, you cannot capture the king. You can never capture the king. So we'll try the second way, that is attack the defender. So we are going to play rook h8. This way of attacking the defender is also called as luring away. So here we are sacrificing something so that the piece moves away while capturing that free piece. So here we are giving him a rook free and in return we'll be getting the queen. So it is compulsory for black to capture the rook, and then once the defender is moved away, defender is forced to move away, we'll get the queen for free. Okay, again, now we are black in this position. Let's see what we are attacking. Yes, we are attacking the queen. And right now the queen is supported. So we have to do something about this bishop. If we can remove this bishop away, then we'll get the queen for free. There is no way we can capture the piece, capture the bishop, because we are not attacking the bishop. Also, if we try attacking the bishop and trying to move the bishop away, then he will simply capture our queen first. So here we have to find some other way. That other way is white's king is trapped on the back rank and this bishop is guarding the back rank. Bishop is the only defender of the back rank. So we can say this bishop is overworked. This bishop is controlling, or this bishop is defending lot of things. So we'll divert the defender. We are going to play rook a1 check. Now, if he captures the rook, we are getting the queen for free. And if he blocks the check with the bishop, we are still getting the queen for free, because as this bishop is pinned, bishop cannot recapture. So here again, we used remove the defender technique. We found out which piece or which weakness is under attack. Then we found out who is the defender, and then we removed the defender. Now here, the black queen is under attack. The white queen is attacking black queen, and black queen is defended by the rook. So right now it looks like everything is fine in black's position. All the pieces are defended, nothing, no loose ends, no hanging pieces. But again, in this simple looking position, there are hidden tactics. So let's go step by step. Which piece is under attack? Queen. Who is the defender? Rook. So the first way to remove the defender is capture the defender, which is not possible. Second way to remove the defender is attack the defender or lure away the defender, again, which is not possible. So here we'll try this third way. The third way is block the defender. So we have to block this line of defense. And to do that, we are going to play knight g5 check. It's a check. So there is no way black queen can capture our queen. Now, if he captures with the pawn, of course, the connection between rook and queen is broken. And then queen will be hanging. We'll capture the queen for free. And if he captures the knight with the rook, we are going to capture the rook with the pawn. And now that way, we got a rook for a knight. So we won an exchange over here. So here we used block the defender idea. We'll move ahead. Okay, let's see what we can do. We are white, so we need to find out which black piece is under attack. So as you can see, this rook on d2 is under attack. So which piece is under attack? Rook. Who is the defender? The other rook, which is on d8. So let's try and remove the defender. Of course, we cannot capture it and we cannot attack it. Now, if we play rook into rook, he's going to play rook into rook, and that way he will have a better position because his rook will be on the 7th rank. And you know how important it is to keep your rook on the 7th rank. So here we are going to use the technique of block the defender or blocking the defender. So we need to disconnect these two pieces. We need to disconnect the link between these two rooks. So we are going to play bishop d5 check. Now if he moves the king away, then there is no connection between the rooks. And now we can capture this rook for free. And if he captures the bishop, well, we are getting the exchange. We are getting his rook for a bishop, and that way we'll get extra material. Next position. Okay. Now we are white. Let's find out the weaknesses first. In every tactics, you can use double attack weaknesses. That way, double attack weaknesses are universal weaknesses. So let's try and find the weaknesses in this position. We are white, so we have to find black's weaknesses. Of course, one weakness is this back rank. King is trapped inside by his own pawn. So that way, any check on the back rank can be a checkmate. But we need one more weakness. That one more weakness is this rook on c7. This is not so well supported piece. That means a piece which has same number of attacks and same number of defense. As you can see, this rook is attacked once and defended once. So this is not so well supported piece. So let's start and try removing the defender. We are going to play queen into c7. Now, before we move ahead, let's see which idea we are going to use over here. So we have already discussed capture the defender. We have already discussed attack the defender and block the defender. Here we are going to use divert the defender. Divert the defender is used when one defender is defending two or more weaknesses. So here this rook on c8 is defending two weaknesses. He's defending the back rank and he's defending the attacked rook. One rook or one piece cannot be present on two different squares at the same time. So that way we are going to divert the rook on one of the squares. We are going to play queen into c7. Now, if he captures the queen, then there is no one guarding the back rank, and we'll give a simple checkmate. And if he comes to know that a checkmate is coming up, and if he saves the rook, then well, we got a free queen. Oh, sorry, we got a free rook, and of course, we are going to win this game with this extra material. Let's move on to the next puzzle. Okay, let's find out what we are attacking. Of course, we are exchange up in this position, but we will get some extra points, or we'll get some quick win if we go step by step, or if we use this removing the defender technique in this position. So let's see. This bishop looks overworked. Why overworked? This bishop is defending the attacked rook. So as you can see, this rook is already attacked. So this rook is not so well supported piece. So this bishop is guarding the rook. Also, this bishop is doing one more very important thing. This bishop is keeping this rook away from this checkmate square. So that way, this bishop is guarding two different weaknesses. And one piece cannot be present on two different squares at the same time. One piece cannot defend two different weaknesses at the same time. So we are going to divert the bishop on one square, and that way the other weakness can be attacked. So we are going to play a rook into rook check. Of course, bishop has to capture the rook, or else it's a checkmate. So that way bishop is diverted towards the c8 square. And now, as we discussed, or as we planned, we are going to play rook e8 checkmate. So as you can see, removing the defender is a simple technique, is a simple tactic, but you need to learn weaknesses first. You need to learn all those double attack weaknesses. We have already kept a video about double attack, so I suggest you should go through that video first, and then you will understand this concept more effectively. So I hope you understood whatever concepts we discussed in this chapter. So till the next time, thank you very much, everyone.